That is quite a pad, isn't it?
Rosie, nice to see you again.
All right. Hello. Tea. Okay.
Hello, boys and girls. Hello.
This is Inca and Jonah.
Wow.
This is beautiful. So how long have you been here, then?
34 years now.
What state was it in when you bought it?
It was a big licorice allsort. Every beam was bright black gloss and every panel was white.
Oh, God, really?
Inside and out.
Before taking Drew to her sales showroom, Rosie's giving him a private tour of her Elizabethan house. He wants to see her legendary collection of personal antiques.
This is our panelled room where we...
Was this here?
It was here, but if I tell you, it was painted dark brown.
You know, you can always tell a lot about a dealer when you go into their house. You know, you can always see, oh, yeah, they're really good. Well, let's go and have a look at the showroom, and I'd love to see more of the outside of the house as well, please. I've known Rosie for a few years, but known about her for my whole career. A real pro, sort of a bit of a doyen of the antiques trade, well-respected and very much liked by everybody in the business. She's very much sort of antiques royalty, I'd say.
It's a step out of the back door and down the path to Rosie's very grand showrooms in a pair of outbuildings. It's almost like an extension of her own home.
So this is the shop now?
Yeah, we go in here, mind the step.
Not very much of a commute, is it? Talk about handy. It's got the perfect setup, isn't it, to really be working from home these days in the business.
Though off the beaten track, the showrooms are open to the public.
It's wonderful. Look at that bed. This is one of your specialities, isn't
it? Well, we do. We do a lot of four-posters, so we've got 23 at the moment.
Have you?
And they've even got one in your size.
Rosie has a certain look, and it's English, country house, 18th century and earlier. Very similar items that all fit together, extremely authentic, which is difficult for me to pick through because I sort of a bit of a magpie. I'll buy anything that I like the look of.
Rosie's high-end collection appeals to a very particular clientele, but Drew's hopeful that there will be bits and pieces hidden away that will be good for his clients.
Oh, and I'm pulling this out. Is this for sale?
Yeah. Everything's for sale, but it's got two broken pieces of glass.
That's a shame, isn't it?
No, three.
There is one thing I find, which is a cast brass lantern, sort of a half size of what I usually buy, but quite a decent quality and a good colour. How much is it, as is?
As is, it's £785.
That's very exact, isn't it, £785? Very. Not many people can do that, can they?
This is just something dropping down, £785.
Here's the glass. Oh, but it's a nice one.
Yeah.
There's glass in the base as well, by the looks of it. No, it wouldn't.
Can I think about that one?
Mm-hmm.
It's about £250 too much. Because I'll want to put the glass back into it, but then I want to spin it over at £150, £200 profit on it, so I can't pay that. So I might have to have a bit of a haggle with her over that.
Sarah Johnson's antique dealership is an island institution. She runs her business under the watchful eye of her St. Bernard dog, Monty.
I was actually born in an antique world and grew up in an antique world. My mother was an ardent collector. She was an antique dealer, and my grandmother as well.
Dealing in everything from Jersey furniture to French crafted pieces and fine garden antiques, business is done by appointment only from a converted barn in the grounds of Sarah's Georgian home.
Come into my emporium.
Fab, can I just start poking around?
Yeah, please poke around.
I like her. She's good.
Yeah, she's Scottish. She's good painting.
Price-wise?
I paid £500 for her. Okay. And
she's going to be staying on Jersey.
We'll keep her.
We'll carry on back through here a bit.
With everything available from glassware, clocks, sofas and paraphernalia...
That's wonderful.
A fire bucket.
Drew needs to be focused on pieces that will complement his existing stock.
We've now come into Sarah's warehouse shop that she has at her house. So convenient, very jealous. There's stuff in here to buy straight away. I can see a few things.
That's lovely, isn't it?
Tell me about this.
These are all typically Jersey. Everyone had one on their beds, and they were all done by hand.
Jersey and the Channel Islands have a strong tradition of intricate knitted and hand-sewn items dating back to the 17th century. This detailed bedspread has exquisite animal and flower detailing and is probably Victorian. It could be worth around £400.
There's one thing I absolutely love, now it's the blanket. The colour's great, you know, and it's double-sided. It just, at the moment, I'm buying so much fabric and blankets and rugs. It works very well if you get like a real big manly chair and then throw this rug across it and photograph it, it works. Price-wise, where are we?
Price-wise, this would be about 150 because it's all hand-done. But this is typical what they had in Jersey. And you can feel the fabric, how old it is.
Well, it's sold.
Oh, you like it?
Love it.
Okay,
thank
fine.
You very
150.
Much. £150. Lovely. All day long, I'll buy those. If she had 10, we'll take them. Lovely, lovely, lovely piece. Very much in touch with my feminine side at the moment.
God, I'm a bit worried about it.
It's all right. The male side's quite strong.
Yeah.
The blanket is a unique find and a great buy for Drew, and it's not long before another elegant item catches his eye.
Tell me about this one, Sarah.
It's just so beautiful. And this would have been somebody's work table. Because you must remember that a lot of people were colonial. They went out into the Far East. Mm.
So it's Japanese export.
Yeah, but it's so beautiful.
Papier-mâché front.
Yeah.
This 19th century sewing table would have been made for export by Japan for the UK market. Gilt chinoiserie seams decorate the underside and the compartment lids. It could be worth around £1,200.
The frame is all timber and then it's got a thick layer of impressed paper and painted, and then it's been lacquered across the top and that's worn away on the top. I've had some really good luck recently selling chinoiserie pieces, so I'll carry on buying them until that luck runs out. How much is it?
This one's 800.
Mm. Okay. I'm not going to bid you on it.
No, don't.
I'd have to upset you, and I don't want to upset you.
Well, what would you offer on it?
I want to buy it. I'm going to have to cut you in half. I'd pay 400, that's it.
Yep, take them.
You sure?
Yep, absolutely.
Trade it on?
Trade it on.
Making a profit?
Yep.
Marvellous. Thank you very much. Very happy with that. I like dealing with dealers. They always want to sell, they always want to buy, they always want to do deals. That's why we're called dealers. And it's great. She's prepared to take profits, take trade prices on things, and let it go out the door. It's a good dealer. Hi, Sheila.
Hello.
How are you doing? Nice to see you.
Hi, and how are you?
I'm good,
hi,
thanks. I'm good.
How are you doing?
Shop looks fab, as usual.
Specialising in 19th and 20th century artwork and furniture, Sheila Hart has been helping to run John Giles Antiques for 30 years, and it's a bit of a Petworth institution.
Traditionally, with Sheila and her partner, I've always done particularly well. They always have good, interesting pieces, real mix, and they price to sell. Tell me about this, then. It's nice. Where'd it come from? Do you know? School or something?
Local.
Just sits particularly well, doesn't it? Love the stretcher.
But it's quite good, and you've got a very good overhang.
Yeah. Yeah, you could use that in a kitchen, couldn't you?
Mm.
This 7-foot-long table made from 2 planks of pine was probably originally used as a refectory or library table. Able to seat up to 10 people, this is ideal for an open-plan, modern interior-designed home. It needs little repair and could be worth around £2,000.
What do you say the best was?
Well, we're hoping to get 12.
I don't want to sort of kick you too hard. Is that it?
£1,150.
Sold. Lovely, thank you very much. Like that, lovely, very, very nice. Very nice. Great, it's exactly why I come to this shop. I can buy something that needs minimal amount of work, that's absolutely bang on for the right money, and turn it over again.